Hi, it's Betty Coons back at you from the library here, from Vibank Library. We're doing a video today on basic sewing. Now today we're hemming a pair of jeans. And this is for people that don't have a sewing machine and just want to do it by hand because they have nothing else available. What I've done first of all is I've taken my pants or my jeans and I put them on me. And then I stood on a chair or had somebody fold underneath, or you could do it yourself, just fold how long you want your pants. So this is how long you want your pants. And then I just put a stick pin in there. And then I've got this left to hem. Now because I'm hemming it, I want to turn this part underneath. So then when I cut, I'm going to cut this much off right here. So I have enough for about a half an inch seam this way, and then the other part will be folded under. I'll show you what I mean in a minute. Meanwhile, I'm going to cut this off, okay? So you allow however much of a hem you want to cut off. That's the much. So for example, this is what where I have it, the pin. And so I want about this much left over. So what I'm gonna do now, because this is fairly straight, I'm just gonna go around the bottom here and cut it all around. So now what I've done is I've cut this much off. Now, it depends upon how long your pants are, okay? But you always allow however much you want the hem for, and then again, you want to turn it in underneath so this saggedy part isn't out in the open so that it's all covered up, all right? Now, I've done that with this leg. Now, the other leg, I'm gonna do the same. Just to make things simpler, I just do the same. I just cut the same amount off the bottom. If you have to cut this much off, you just do the same with the other leg. So now I've got it cut off, and now I'm going to have to hem them. So now what I do is I take the pants, the slacks, and I turn them inside out. And then, what I've done with the needle is I threaded the needle. You can do it just with a single thread and have the other one loose, but I find it's better to have the two together like this, and I put a double knot on the bottom. It's stronger, and you don't have to worry about having that second thread tangling up with your thread while you're sewing. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to just turn this like I'm doing this now, this much. I want this much of a hem, and then I want to turn this over again so that I don't have the cut side out so it won't snag or tear or come looser, get caught on my foot when I'm wearing them. So now because I've done that, then I go like this, and I put my needle in there like this from the inside underneath out. And when I keep turning this over, sometimes it's easier, it depends on the pair of pants, if you press it first, but I usually just do it this way. And then you just come with this, you've taken this like this. I should mention, you always pick the thread that's going to match as close as you can, so it doesn't show on the other side. And then I go in here and I just catch the inside of the pants so it doesn't go right to the outside, otherwise you're going to see your thread on the outside. And then I go like this, and so I'm over top, on the top of the hem, then I go down, under, and I catch the bottom of the thread right there, so I don't go right through to the other side, and then I keep going till I'm done. So what I'm doing here is I'm showing you, because I had done it already before, here you have your two threads. Now you could have it just a single thread and tie a knot like this, or what I usually do for jeans anyways is I go like this and I double it up and then I go to the bottom and I tie them together in a knot. And make a double knot so that it doesn't pull through the material when you're doing the sewing. What I did is I ran out of thread, so now I'm making a second strand of thread to finish up that pant leg. Okay, now I'm almost at the end of my pant leg here that I've done. The main trick is to have nice even stitches and not to go right through the material on the other side, but have enough material caught so that it holds it so that it's not gonna rip loose when you're wearing them. So now I'm coming to the end where my seam is here, and you can see it's nicely fit together here. And this is where the thread left over there when I started. Now I'm just going to go through it one more time. And then what I'm going to do at the end here, when I'm all done, I want another knot, right, so that it doesn't rip loose. So then I'm just going to, I'm a little bit tight here, just take it and I twist it around my needle a bit. And then I put it back through here, and I have a knot. That makes my knot. Now if you find you can't do that, just take your needle, cut your needle off, and just take the two strands of thread and tie a double knot that way, if you don't like to do it this way, if you're not handy with that. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut these two long threads off. And you can see now, I have a nice, even hem. And if you look on this other one here that was sewed by the manufacturer, it almost looks like it, right? But if you have a machine, what you can do is you can do the same thing, fold it over, and then just sew a seam right through along inside. And this is a little bit neater because you don't see the thread. Now I'll do the same with the other leg, and the pants will be done. What we're going to do is we're going to come back a little bit later and we're going to show you how to do a pair of dress pants. A pair of dress pants, you'd want to have a bigger hem, a good inch of a hem, and there's different methods you can do with that too. This is just a plain pair of jeans, which you can see now on this side, you don't see the thread at all, and it's nice and even all the way around. Good job. So you can just put your pants on and off you go. So come back again to Vibank Library and we'll be happy to show you two more series of sewing. Bye.